We should be back. So, hello again, and back to our second half of the stream with our bounty hunter, our power tech. Let's see what we can continue story-wise there. The music is a lot louder than I remember. Ooh. Although I guess the intro was always a bit loud. And hello everyone in chat, thank you for staying. After me failing repeatedly for 3 hours to get that boss. I see we're doing the dad jokes again. You mean you are hungry, Sly, but you think you can manage. Hello, you are hungry, Sly. You think you can manage. I'm Uli, and that is Mac. So, hello. Okay, so here we are. Tagaro has his companion and is now trying to get Krista to give him his next mission.
Hey there, Hunter. Competition out there is something crazy.
Couple of hunters died in the jungles. Big Trandoshan got arrested by the Imperials.
And you found yourself an unfindable Republic noble. His family was plenty generous with their live bounty.
Nobody should have to go through what that man suffered.
Heart of a poet, gun like a capital ship. I'm like to swoon. Your second bounty's a bit of a mystery. Apparently, whoever's stacking the deck against you gonna keep right on stacking.
Hardly surprising.
What I got here is a classified red flag request from Imperial Command. No details, just flashy warnings and a contact. Admiral Frabal, Imperial Navy.
I don't see what the big deal is.
You haven't dealt much with Imperials, have you? They make huts look downright honest.
Here's the slip. Frabal's in the city, not all that far a stroll. Go get him.
All right. So whatever we got there. What is it? A generator. Whatever that is for. Well, it gives me stats, so it's not as if I'm too... if I complain about it. And so that's a lot better rating than we had before. Good. Oh, does our thing still work? Snowball bomb? Yeah, I guess the event isn't yet over. So I guess we'll keep trying that. So yeah, back to work for you, Sly. Okay, thanks for dropping by and have fun at work. I guess this game kind of looks like work to you too. Didn't see that. There is a lore item. Let's get that. Gives us some XP. And an entry. Wait, am I running in the wrong direction? No, I'm not. This is the way out. Okay. It's always, like in all other, like for all other classes, this room is like usually at the same level or higher than the entrance. But for the Mandalorians, it's lower, and so I don't think of going upstairs to get outside. You know, there's like three, I don't know if you can see that well from here. Like over there is another such exit. That's the Imperial intelligence, I think. Oh no, wait, that's in the middle is probably... Sith, and on the other end, back there, that's Imperial Intelligence with the sunroof, right. You should make a female bounty hunter named Amanda Lorian. Yes, yes, I loved that joke. With, I don't know if you've seen that, there was this really fun tweet, like, I mean, Halbath obviously seen it, but, there was this tweet, from someone, you know, like, oh, if you're looking, and there was a picture of the Mandalorian from the TV show. If you look like this, contact me. And then someone said, oh, you want to talk to Amanda? And then he said, like, Amanda who? And then, and then the answer was, well, Amanda Lorian. No, it was no spoiler for The Mandalorian. Don't worry. I can't even spoil The Mandalorian because we won't have it until April.
Do you get the feeling that we're really out of place here?
Yes, I get the feeling we're really out of place here. Oh, wait. That was the wrong entrance? Oh, I guess I just... Let's go back... Where was the exit? Was it this one? No. Damn it. I went the wrong way. Cricket sounds. Yeah, and I know I told it to like most people who've already seen it, and also telling a picture joke in verbal form probably doesn't help either. But hey. Somehow I thought it needed it could use some explaining, and I regret nothing. Well, I regret a little bit that, but anyway. Boing. It's always so weird that they don't put your companion next to you into those shuttles or something, or, you know, put them in a shuttle behind you or something like that. Seems like such a simple thing to do, and this game is otherwise so immersive. And then there's this thing where it's just like your companion disappears and pops up again later. Just doesn't exist for the moment in between. Should have sucked heaven to wait for Destiny Plus to release. Oh boy. Let's put it this way. I live in a lawyer happy city, and I'm not looking to pay a couple thousand euros just to watch a TV show.
This is the office of Admiral Frabal of the Imperial Navy. Do you have business here?
I'm here to see the Admiral. Let me in.
I'm afraid the Admiral is not seeing vagrants today. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy.
If you'll excuse me, I'm gonna shoot you in the head.
I didn't want to shoot him in the head.
This is the office of Admiral Frabal of the Imperial Navy. Do you have business here?
I'm here to see the Admiral. Let me in.
I'm afraid the Admiral is not seeing vagrants today. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy.
Let me in there. Now.
I really couldn't care less what you...
What's all that racket out there, soldier?
There's a quarrelsome individual here, Admiral. Rather dirty, too.
Quarrelsome? You're as weak as you are stupid. I requested a mercenary from the Mandalorians. Send that person in immediately.
Yes, sir. You may go in now.
I'll bet you get a demerit for that, Lieutenant.
You're terrible.
The Admiral is waiting.
Kind of fitting that he said there's an individual out there, kind of dirty as well, and then Mac comes, oh, I think I'll go take a bath and read some Witcher. Yeah, thanks for being here. Have fun reading The Witcher. Remember, there's an official Witcher taking a bath pose that you are required to assume for the entire reading. There will be... we will be checking surveillance later. Okay. Max says you're getting Disney Plus at the end of next year. So not at the end of this year, but next year, 2021? So once season 2 has finished, good job, Disney. Yeah. Maybe before, you're not sure if they're targeting November or December or whatever. Just said end of 2020. Oh, so end of this year. Okay, you remember that it's already 2020. Don't write 2019 on your checks and complaints to Disney. You're not required to provide photographic evidence of you in said pose, though. Well, I don't know. We might be able to sell it for something. It might be useful. Okay, so let's talk to our general, then.
Come in, mercenary. I apologize if my secretary caused you grief. He is of low birth, and his intelligence reflects it. I'm afraid many of our Imperial soldiers are hopeless with delicate tasks. This is, of course, why I asked for a professional.
If it's delicate you want, it's delicate you'll get.
I have every faith in the Mandalorian Enclave's ability to get things done discreetly. My daughter has become something of a liability to me. I want you to kill her.
That's something you don't hear every day.
Then I'll assume you're newly arrived to Dromund Kuss. Things work a bit differently here. My daughter was born force-sensitive and trained to be Sith. A great honor for our family. Unfortunately, my daughter's master is one Lord Grathen, a madman who is now disgraced in the eyes of the Dark Council.
Why not just get her a new master?
It's outside of my control. The Sith manage their own affairs, the rest of us merely suffer the consequences. If Lord Grathen's compound is raided and my daughter captured or killed, every member of her family will suffer. This is Sith politics. In the best case scenario, I lose my rank and position. In the worst...
This is one messed up way to run a planet.
You deal with the empire you have, not the one you might wish you had. Lord Grathen is a paranoid madman. His compound is built to withstand a siege, but a lone infiltrator will take them by surprise. My daughter is somewhere inside Lord Grathen's compound. Her name is Veretta. You will know her as she resembles me closely.
I'm trying to remember, like, a daughter resembling him closely.
Is there going to be fallout for taking down a Sith?
Not as long as nobody knows what happened.
Hang on, I've been running some data. Turns out renegade Sith Lord followers rack up death marks like crazy. Lord Grathen's top people all have prices on their heads.
It'd be a shame to let those bounties go to waste.
And we might need those extra credits to gear you up for the big melee.
Remember, discretion is essential. Do not let yourself be captured. Good luck.
All right. One thing I almost forgot. There. Merry Christmas, sir. And I thank him as well. So let's catch up on you people in chat. I don't want to ignore you. Whoops, I accidentally pushed a button. Okay. Sell it as an unconventional weapon of mass destruction. Yeah, that would be one way, yeah. You guarantee similar effect to the funniest joke from Monty Python. Numlums fixed it. Okay, what did you fix? But congrats, because fixing something is always good. Except if it's like the Death Star or something and you're, you know, about to blow up Alderaan. But I guess that in that case it depends on what class and alignment you're playing, of course. Ba-dum. Sorry. Always forget that I don't have to say it. Alright, so we want to go somewhere over there and find a Sith to kill. The funniest joke in Monty Python was really good. But, well... You know, Monty Python has a number of quite fun jokes. But, I fondly remember it. I guess we can take a speeder there so you don't have to watch me drive to it in my little motorcycle. Oh, we can sell the old thing here.
Use all products only as intended.
And repair our armor.
Be well.
And then hopefully use
ready for departure.
This. The walls.
Enjoy
sounds good.
Stay.
So did Num Nums mention before what was broken? Oh, it was something about a... something you wanted to send. Okay.
Whee!
I mean, this is kind of a nice way of having fast travel. I mean, it's... obviously stolen from World of Warcraft again. They have something similar where you're riding on one of these things. Oh, right, we can pick up this mission. By the way, if you're doing if you've played Knights of the Old Republic, the original game that kind of was the inspiration for this MMO, and you're playing an Imperial, once you get to Dromund Kaas and get in this area, be sure to do this mission.
Ah, mercenary. Already word of your feats has reached those knowledgeable in Kaas City. I am the apprentice and voice of Darth Charnas. I speak in his name and I would bargain for your services.
I'm paying attention.
I require individuals capable of gaining prestige in a society weaned on secrecy and madness. Individuals who can earn respect, if not love. I need infiltrators to eliminate an enemy of the Sith. You would serve well.
You're wanting to hire me?
If you like. Our enemy is the Order of Revan, a cult of fools hidden at every stratum of Imperial society. For years, the Revanite heretics have secretly recruited military officers, powerful Sith, wealthy mercenaries, anyone who can add to their power.
You want me to join them, I take it.
I want you to help my master ruin them. Instead of following the Emperor and his Dark Council, the Revanites follow a long-dead Sith Lord, tainted by Jedi ways. If you can uncover the Revanite leader's identity for us, my master will reveal him to the Dark Council. His destruction would be assured. All you have to do is join the cult. I can get you inside, but you must earn their trust.
Right, thanks for the pointer. I am updating the game.
You got a plan?
The Revanites have a secret compound in the jungle. Take this token to the cultist at the entrance. He will initiate you. Earn an audience with their leader. When you have seen his face, return here, and you shall have your reward.
All right. So that's it's a purple mission, so you're supposed to do it anyway. To get, like, the right amount of experience, but technically you could skip it. So, that's why I like to point it out, and also because it ties in, like, if you've heard the name Revan, that character also plays a role, plays a role in, Knights of the Old Republic. But, by the way, if you... if you're worried, like, if you haven't played Knights of the Old Republic yet, that mission is not really a spoiler. Oh, someone already mowed down all the enemies here? Huh. What's going on? Usually there should at least be dead bodies. Ah, now they're back. Okay. Anyway, so it's that side mission that we just picked up is easy to, like, you can hear it, and it just ties in with the background, basically, of that other game, as far as I remember. So it's not a big spoiler. It's interesting that there's, like, everyone has basically been eliminated here. Ah, now you're back. Come on, let's shoot these people. Alright. Oof. Snowflake robot. It's also like a lot in Star Wars The Old Republic. You get, like, this is an area that basically everyone goes through with a slightly different reason. Like, one person is to take out, you know, like Gratham themselves. Someone else is to take out his assistant. Things like that. So, it's a clever way. Oh, by the way, these are, like, harvest nodes. So, like, you can get certain abilities to pick up stuff, and then if you do that, yeah, so if you get these harvesting abilities, then you can you can pick those up and get, like, credits from them or other stuff while you're doing missions. So just an extra reason to do certain missions or even, you know, run through these areas again. Just to get some stuff. Alright, I presume I'm still online. It's gone a little quiet. I guess, Control is more interesting than Star Wars. Especially since this is way more simple combat-wise. Basically, I'm just pushing buttons. Oh. I've got something important. Forgot to trigger this ability. It should make us all better. Whoops. And of course I triggered these enemies. It'll be interesting to see whether, like, I could see that this Christmas event is over now. But the item still works. So I'm kind of wondering, does it never stop working? Or am I just not having luck with the random number generator right now? Here again, everyone is has been shot. Well, I guess it's good that I can just run through for now and don't have to shoot them all, but... Alright. Got you dead. Defeat Grathan Estate Overlords is an extra mission. Where are the overlords? Okay, that's the... They are in there. Good. It almost feels a little silly to get experience just by running into a new era and getting that one bit of XP that pushes you over. What can you harvest from a black metallic block? It better be chocolate cake, otherwise I'm not interested. Yeah, in this case it's just a safe containing money, sadly. But you know you can buy chocolate with money. Weep. All right. Let's see what we can do here. I actually just recently on another character went through this area, and it's interesting to see, like, it's slightly different, but not that much. Okay, they're all in there. Like, for another mission, you have to go up here and take out those people. So it's kind of funny how they just stand in there and you don't care about them. Oh, wait. Wrong exit. Up. Hello. And actually, the other mission... I should have actually started the Revan mission, done the Revan's mission before this. Because basically, there is something in this area. In there as well.
I'm not just a pretty sidekick, Buster.
Right. Got the first overlord. The last one, somewhere up there, I guess. Back there, okay. All right, done the bonus mission. Talk to this lady.
Oh, what have we here? You're not even a Mandalorian, are you? When Lord Grathan's spy said my father contacted the Mandalorian Enclave, I expected they'd at least send me a real live Mandalorian. I'm afraid I'm a tad disappointed.
What does it matter who kills you?
A woman has to have standards. Wait, you don't seriously think you can kill me? I mean, I'm a Sith, and you're just... whatever you are.
Oh, we've got a true believer.
Then again, it makes sense. Why would you come here if you thought you'd die? Apparently, my father isn't the only one living in a dream world. You can't kill a Sith, you silly.
You believe you're invincible, little girl?
No, of course not. A more powerful Sith could kill me. Or a really lucky Jedi, I suppose. Perhaps a bomb, but not some random bounty hunter. You must be so crushed. Live and learn, I guess. Except, not in your case. Sorry.
Ah!
right. Not stand in her lightning storm. Mainly rely on my companion to heal me. That's it.
What? I lost? I can't lose. I'm Sith.
Someone's been filling your head with garbage.
Can't die like this, falling to some common bounty hunter. Everything Lord Grothan told me was a lie. I've been living in a dream world. It can't end like this. It can't.
I guess we're playing light side. Wait, am I playing light side? Let me check. Yeah, I'm playing light side. Okay, just so I don't misremember.
What?
Let's go back there.
Someone.
Well, then I guess we're letting her live.
It's time you and your father had a chat. What?
No, that's worse.
Oh, this can't end well. Does she look like her father? Same hairstyle. Does she have the same hairstyle? Kinda seemed a little... I don't know, I don't quite remember his hairstyle. I mean, the color is roughly... in the similar ballpark. Okay, I guess we can do the Revan mission another time and just go back there and finish this. True hairstyle is genetically inherited. See? Yes, alright. He's got carbonite as a Spider-Man wrist spray. Yes, we got that last time.
Well, this place looks lively. I guess the Imperials have something that passes for fun after all.
Wait, did I get crew skills last time? Yes, okay. But I don't have a gathering skill yet. Wherever we get those. Okay. Because the crew skill trainers for certain things are here. Someone threw a snowball at us. Alright, we want to go over there again. Boing. This is a pretty square, by the way, with all those burning, kind of evil, dark burning pyramid thingies and that statue in the middle. The building behind it. So they really did some good work on the areas in this game. Although it's kind of like, you know, it's a bit... Oh, and this old obelisk here as well. Although, you know, like, it feels kind of low detail. Wait. You get another snowball. Yes, I got another parcel. Good. Right, and I think I'll wait a second for the cooldown on my snowball here. Sorry about that. Come on. All right, and now we talk.
Reports of the raid on Lord Grathan's estate are pouring in. I trust you were successful in your endeavor. My daughter, Veretta, is...
If you wish you could have changed my orders, you're in luck.
You froze her. Why? I was so specific in my directions. Why in the galaxy would you do this? Why would you refuse a specific order and not eliminate the target?
I figured it was a family affair.
You're incredibly insightful for a bounty hunter. As soon as you left the premises, I realized my mistake. A mistake that would haunt me the rest of my days.
We weren't about to let that happen, sir.
You've done me a great service, Hunter. She's all I have of her mother.
You're not gonna kill her?
No, of course not. Contain her, maybe, until she can be made to see reason. Here is your writ and your fee. Now, please, I need some time with my daughter.
Yay. I think this is actually... I think the last time I didn't kill her on a character, it was... I gave a wrong answer here, and so he was basically angry at me. So I guess this went well. Yay, we saved a Sith! Wait. Damn it. The detail is in your imagination. Waves hand and a rainbow appears. Ah, rainbows. Spaceships, lightning. Ooh, I love the effects in the clouds. Do you see that? Like, when the lightning comes up, you see, like, different clouds in there. That's a cool idea for an effect. You know, it's fairly simple because, you know, it's probably just like a painting, like the skybox, and then they just show like a different thing on there that has the lightning animation and the different clouds. So there's no actual depth to it. At least not in the engine. Maybe the original image was generated from a 3D image. But it's a very nice detail, you know, to kind of give the planet that more oppressive atmosphere that, like, the Imperial homeworld would need. Some pro clouds. Yeah. Alright, so... back to the Enclave. Mandalorian Enclave. 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 Something I'm mispronouncing something, like it's like French-ish the pronunciation in English, but something enclave I think, or something, I don't know. I could just call it enclave and be done with it, I guess. Maybe it's a little enclavchen.
Second bounty is done. Just one more, and I'm in the melee.
Right you are. And competition is heating up. That little green girl, Iopian Rattle, finished all her bounties. Heard she poisoned an Imperial moth.
Lucky we didn't get that one. Not sure how we'd work it out.
Now, I ain't allowed details on whatever you were scrapping for Admiral Fabal. But I got a clearance note says it was duly scrapped. Nice payday, too.
Professionals don't talk about their clients.
I hear you. Less I know, the better. Here we go. Bounty 3. I call it, someone's got a serious hate for my hunter. Top secret, crazy, red flag covered. This one's for a Captain Metal in Imperial Intelligence. No other information.
What exactly is Imperial Intelligence?
Spook arm of the Empire. Secrets, lies, and things that don't need asking about. Watch yourself with those people. Stay careful. Get this one done, and don't get yourself dead in the process.
Alright, and we get the choice of... pets. Okay, so these ones... What one easy way, if you already made the choice once, is... oh, which one do I need to take again, is to look... like, if everything goes up, then that probably means it's the same kind you had. Here, some abilities actually go down, so that's probably the other one. That's like for a tank, I guess, if it has defense rating and absorption rating. So, Always nice in MMOs to have that. 34. That's the one. And the credits we get as well. By the way, usually like it counted up here, but you can see in your chat up here somewhere how much it evens out to. Okay, so let's see. This is all junk stuff we sell, and this is another snow-covered parcel. Weird. I thought I'd already gotten a few parcels. Why do I only have one? Did I accidentally sell them? Or did I just not get anything last time? I don't know. Oh, and there is new stuff to learn. Neural dart. And an energy shield, finally.
Warmy topi.
Alright, so let's go to interior Imperial Intelligence. And that's also nice. I mean, it's on one hand, you know, it's a game design, you know, like a cost-saving measure to reuse certain maps and things like that. But it also ties it all together better. Because since the three places are together here and like all the Imperial classes come by here, you can just you're going into the area like that is the equivalent the equivalent to the Mandalorian enclave for the Imperial agent, which is another class you can play. And the Imperial Agent is actually the other character that starts out on Hutta, where the Bounty Hunter starts. So if you want to play together, and one of you wants to play a Bounty Hunter, that's usually the best idea. And basically this will be, hey, I'll be visiting my friend in their, you know, department. Which is, you know, like a nice detail.
What the?
Oh, right. The Bounty Hunter. Glad you could make it. You nervous, Hunter? Parked in the middle of Imperial Intelligence and all.
I could say one word or touch one button and you'd disappear forever.
Poof. Gone. Just like that. No one would even dare to ask what happened to you.
Are you threatening me, Captain?
What? What the?
Oh, right. You
can poof.
Go ahead. Say the word and see what happens.
Nicely done. I like you, Hunter. I really do. I never signed up for this cloak and dagger stuff. I was a regular soldier. Then one day, I put together a covert op raid that goes a little too well. And bam, I'm in Imperial Intelligence. Look, what I'm saying is the stuff that goes on in these halls is insane, and all of it is crazy hush-hush. So what I'm going to tell you has to stay just between you and me. Got it?
My price tag always includes the cost of discretion.
Here's the deal. There's a huge ancient Sith temple on Drummond Cuss, used to just sit there being scary. Now the place is crawling with Sith sorcery, and it's been ordered a no-go zone for everyone. Naturally, we sent a team in. My commander led that team. Nobody came back. We can't report any of them dead without reporting the mission, which puts me in a bind.
I still don't see what you need me for.
If I can't prove my commander's dead, I can't take over his spot, which means an ugly power vacuum. I'm hiring you to enter that temple and find the team's ID cards, especially my commander's. I need those IDs to create more acceptable deaths for them.
It's a done deal.
I tell you, I envy you getting to do the fun part. Make sure you find an Imperial commander named Gargan. Can't imagine there'll be more than one corpse in a temple wearing commander stripes. Grab all the team's ID cards and double time it back here quietly.
All right. Let's find us some lost Imperials then. Are they playing Tetris on these things? No, I guess they're just lighting up certain things. Interesting. Alright, let's see where we gotta go. Spy game. That's where we're going. A cool idea to have these huge cities. These lines sometimes get a little janky, like the speeder routes. Like, it seems like a while ago some of them just ended up being slightly under the floor if you fly through them. If you land, it's okay at that point. But like, the landing points that you pass through kind of always seem to be, you know, too steep and in the ground. And these these speeder flights always cost a few credits. So when I started out, I always went like, oh my god, I don't know, I won't have enough credits, so I better not fly with these speeders. And so I walked all these distances, and then you encounter enemies, and it just everything takes so long. So in short, yeah, better not do that. Okay, so we're at the outpost. Guess we don't have to do these missions, although we could if we wanted to. So let's head over where the map says we should go. And given you get a good amount of experience from just playing the regular stuff, I'm gonna try to avoid most of the enemies if I can. I think it goes up here. Also looks interesting. Isn't that a nice temple? And everywhere in the sky are big spaceships. Yeah, I know, it's the same spaceship in the skybox, but it kind of adds to, you know, the idea that this is a huge place where many ships are in orbit at a time. Especially capital ships like those. Zip. So we could, you know, fight all of these if we wanted to. Thank you for clearing that space. So let's go through the Dark Temple. Okay, we need to go down there. Can we do that without attracting anyone? Ah, looks like we can. It's free enough. Everyone kind of goes crazy here. This player is kind of chipping away at this enemy quite a lot. Oh, right. I think we have stuff that we wanted to sell.
Yes.
Sell junk. Repair. And we have better ones than these as well. Another parcel. Nice. If I remember correctly, these parcels are actually not bound to characters, so if you're like me and like to play different stories at the same time, you can actually, no matter what you play, you know, you can get all those parcels and then send them to one of your characters and have them trade them in for something useful. So that's nice.
I can still hear them talking. I cut off my holo receiver, but I can still hear them. If I lose it, please don't leave me down here.
It's nice that they have this, I don't have a healing ability, otherwise I could help. Okay, where do we want to go? Somewhere there, ID tags, 0 of 5, so we just have to find troopers. That's a Sith neophyte. Don't need that. Sith neophyte. That's a trooper. Shield. That reduces a little bit of damage. Okay, one ID tag. Two ID tag. No. That's another thing that one with the can get with the harvesting skin skill. I really gotta look up where those harvesting trainers are. I think there's been a bounty hunter somewhere before me. It's also empty here. Alright, let's see. No, what was it? Be nice if you could say, hey, I only need troopers, and you know, you could only attack troopers, and some other player could get the could get the enemies that they need. Basically, you're always like, it's always a team of several. Stole my trooper. Hostage. I mean, that probably means I'm not doing enough damage. Oh, there's another trooper. Although that Sith seems to be. Sith. Oops. All right, got you two. One more trooper. Like that one, for instance.
pretty sidekick, Buster.
Not even two. We only need one. Okay, now we need to find Commander Gargan. How we know where he is, I have no idea, but apparently he is. Why are you a speaker for the dead? Isn't that the wrong book franchise? Or franchise in general? The Sith are taking them hostage and you are killing the Sith and the spies? Well, it's basically everyone in this temple goes mad. You have to kill and lose the lost victims yourself. Well, they're possessed, so I can't really do anything with them. So that's basically my choice. I don't have a way to unpossess them. I'm not like a Sith or a Jedi or something who could maybe do that.
What is this in front of me? Another worshipper?
Who braves the flames of the Altar of Horror to stand in front of Lord Barrel Slathborn, Lord of the Sith?
Captain Metal sent me to find you, Commander.
There is no commander here. And if there were, he would be my minion. Imperials serve the Sith Lords.
If you're not an Imperial Commander, then what's that ID card for?
What madness do you speak? I have no... Oh, that... It seems the ID of some Imperial commander I must have slain has stuck to my robes. Do you wish to have it? A token of your visit with the great Lord Barrel Slathborn?
Oh, thank you, my lord. That's very generous of you.
It is settled then. A token for you. Go forth now and spread word to all who worship lesser lords. Lord Barrel Slathborn is mightiest among all mighty lords of the Sith.
I don't think I've done that before. Like, it's a fun combination. Like, the things that are... It's always, like, slight differences in SWTOR. Depending on, you know, like, what you play as. Like, it's, well, not everything. Like, as a alien or human, there is... The differences are very small. Occasionally, some people... You know, especially on the Empire, like mention, oh, those filthy aliens and things like that, and then they tell you, well, of course not you, or something like that. Or you can address it and say, that's it. Not that's it. Lost my train of thought there. Well, but oh, that gift droid doesn't seem to be. Oh, so I guess. I guess I got him to cool off. Or it actually. Weird. Okay. Anyway, yeah, but like, male, female makes a big difference. Every class has a slight difference in stories, and your decisions make big differences sometimes. Like, they're not, you know, the decisions, many of them are just like for this mission, or for like how they react to you, how quickly they attack you or something, but it's fun to roleplay like that.
You got the IDs? Fantastic. Let me see. That's Commander Gargan's, all right. What was it like in the Dark Temple? I've yet to hear anything that didn't sound like pure raving.
There was an entire society in that temple. Well, kinda.
Huh. Still wish I could have got him myself. Would have saved me some unpleasantness. Listen to me. Unpleasantness. I'm even starting to talk like a spy. Friend, remember when I said Sith didn't want anyone in the Dark Temple?
I remember all right.
Well, you can probably guess the rest. I can't risk the Sith ever finding out you went into their precious Dark Temple, which means you're now a liability. I apologize. This isn't the way a fighting man should die. Guards!
You're gonna get it now.
That's not nice of you. Focusing that on. That's not nice. You don't do that to a bounty hunter.
That went wrong, didn't it? Got a hole in my gut. I'm not going to beg. Turning on someone who did their job is wrong. We both know it. Here's your writ. It tells the Mandalorians you did your job. And here's your pay. The rest is up to you.
Are you gonna send more men after me?
To do what? Add to the body count. My men are no match for you. How about I make a more concrete apology? I'll send you some top-of-the-line weaponry as soon as you're out of here. That work for you?
I'm glad this didn't have to get personal.
It never was. Believe me, you're everything a man should be. I wish I'd... Well, it's too late for regrets. What's done is done. Good hunting to you.
Interesting not killing him. You just survived against a million Sith and he thinks his guards are better? Yeah, that's kind of... I guess, you know, since nobody is allowed in there, you know, he just thinks, you know, everyone is exaggerating. This mission, of course... No, wait, I'm trying... No, I think only the bounty hunter gets this mission. But, like... The others get to go in the temple as well, and it kind of, you know, it makes sense. To be for like Sith to be able to go in that temple because they might be used to, you know, being attacked by other Sith in some psychic way or something, so you can say, well, they have the Force, they can shield themselves and things like that. But it kind of feels weird to oh wait, one more. Yeah, but like for a bounty hunter to just go in there and come out there and not be hurt or mad or whatever, that's kind of unusual. And like same for the Imperial agent, it's kind of a lot of this kind of SWTOR makes a little less sense for the non-Force users. It, you can tell that it was mainly designed around the Force users. Crate dragon or something skull, I guess. Guess they show off that they can kill huge beings. I mean, it's, you know, it's difficult. People want Star Wars, so of course you want Sith and you want the Force. But then, what do you do, with the other classes, like the smuggler and things like that? Of course, you know, like Han Solo wouldn't fight against Darth Vader, but basically that's kind of what this game sometimes gives you.
You're alive! Some Mandalorian big shot named Taro Blood said you were dead. They're about to start the melee without you.
I can't wait to kill that man.
You're gonna have to wait until after the melee.
All the other hunters who survived are already inside. Get in there.
If I die, bury my credits with
me. Oh, no, no, no. That's not You're what alive. This character would say.
I can't. You all. Nothing will stand in my way.
That's the spirit.
Also, like, one obvious difference is, how Krista treats you. If you're a male bounty hunter, she kind of flirts with you, which you might remember from the previous mission. Otherwise, she, you know, she just, like, is your pal. So that's interesting.
And the last hunter left standing joins the great hunt. Simple as that. All weapons are allowed, but you fight alone. No assistance. And it looks like we have a latecomer.
Somebody made up a story I was dead.
Your competitors were relieved to hear it. Too bad for them, huh? Huntmaster, will you do us the honor?
Today, many hunters earn glory in death and defeat. One hunter... Good hunting to all.
We all heard tales of your exploits, Hunter. Perhaps I'll turn them into a song to commemorate your death.
I'll do the same. You prefer ballads or war chants?
I prefer to win. I'd wish you luck, but it wouldn't help. So I'll just say goodbye.
Enough! You hunters are the best that the galaxy's goons and thug lords could send us. Now show us which one of you will join the great hunt. Fight!
The weird thing is that they don't turn off my companion for this battle. So I'm actually kind of, like, he says no companions, but I'm actually getting...
I'm not scared of you.
Oh, I forgot to throw the snowball, sorry. Can't just shoot the other guy. Okay, I guess they shot each other.
The melee is over. One hunter remains.
They have a fast cleanup crew. Everyone was already gone.
Quite a show you put on. Blasted fun to watch. How do you feel, Hunter?
I just stomped my competition into the dirt. I feel great.
Enjoy it. Things only get harder from here.
Let the hunter stand before me. He is honored be all common. For all common, let it be known.
This is simply ridiculous. I mean, really. This needs to stop right now.
Are we starting the hunt already?
No! No! No unsanctioned kills in the Great Hunt!
You see? That's a perfect example. I object to this farce. This ignorant thug does not deserve to enter the Great Hunt. His credentials are a lie, fabricated by his little gutter rat of a sidekick. He deserves no honors.
You lying, cheating, murdering scum!
We know this hunter's history, Blood. The Huntmaster has ruled.
You fools! This is a place of honor, a competition of elites. Mandalore will hear of this.
What do I want to say? Like, I want to... Running away, take it up with the Wookiee. I think I'll go with take it up with the Wookiee.
If you feel so strongly about it, fight the Huntmaster.
Enough! Before this great hunt is over, I will have your skull in my hands.
Well, the Great Hunt just got way more interesting. Sorry to interrupt, Huntmaster. Please continue.
The Great Hunt proves talent, resolve. Mandalore calls it to bring him the most good people. Each hunter will hunt the other's prey, then each hunter hunts the other. At the end, there is no prey and only one hunter.
You get all that, Hunter?
Just tell me that Taro Blood is my prey.
If he isn't yet,
He will be eventually.
You'll be hunting targets spread across the galaxy. There'll be at least one other hunter going for them too. You not only have to take down your target, you have to eliminate the other hunters.
What if I don't get to my targets first?
Then you'll have hunters gunning for you instead of the other way around.
There you go, truly the hunter, and all else is your prey. Welcome to the Great Hunt.
Your handler, Krista, will fill you in on the rest of the details. She's waiting for you.
I like that they gave the Wookiee those big speeches. The first time they did that, I had to stop myself from laughing. Oh, I still have the ability selected. Interesting.
Oh, what a thrashing! The other handlers are all bug-eyed jealous you won. Now, on to the Great Hunt. I expect you want to hear about your targets.
Tell me everything I need to know.
Here's how it's gonna work. First, you're getting a starship.
How's that gonna happen?
Well, let's just say you're not quite done here on Dromund Kaas.
On your ship's computer, you'll access two holo recordings, both with specific details on who and where you hunt.
What's Terrell Blood gonna be doing?
The same thing. That's how the Great Hunt works. Each target will have another hunter assigned to it. You have to locate that rival and take him out, too.
Maybe we'll get lucky and Terrell Blood will be on our first target.
Now, about your ship. There's a tradition for new hunters. You've got to steal one for yourself.
Guess I'll be heading to the spaceport.
Not quite yet. Gotta find you the right ship first.
Gotcha. I know one that belongs to one of them so-called importer types. Fast, smooth, and roomy.
I'll pull together your holo recordings for the Great Hunt targets and transmit them when you hit space. Meantime, head to the spaceport. Get past whatever guards are around, steal your ship, and hit the hyperlanes.
I'm off on the Great Hunt.
Your first round of targets are on Balmorra and Nar Shaddaa. Good luck to you, Hunter.
All right. Blaster pistol and demolisher. Bolt blaster. I think I was bolt blaster. Let's see, what does it power? Critical rating, tech power. And that one is defense. So yeah, that's probably the one I want. Is that bastard better than mine? It has a little bit more damage. And a little bit more tech power. But I guess I can stay with mine for now. And I have armor that is better. Forgot to put it on. Okay. Sorry, Krista, but too close. Okay. You get a snowball. By the way, these figures here... Oh, these are just decoration, okay. There are some of those around. They're training dummies that you can actually use. Be a little bit careful because some of them are bugged and they won't stop being in combat. And so you might, like, lock yourself out of the mission and might have to, like, Alt F4 out of the client to actually... to actually get back in there. Hello?
What's your pinky?
Use the duration of energy shield per 3 seconds. Okay, that's a passive. That's nice. Heroic moment. Seize a moment restoring 2% of your maximum health. But usually heroic moment is gives you class gives you legacy abilities. So the thing is, if you level a character, to the end of their class story, you get the ability, get one ability from that class, basically unlocked for all your characters, and that's how you trigger it. So I guess I can just trigger it. Yeah, you see this bar, so that's like all the abilities that you can get. So it's like the orbital strike, I think, is from the Imperial agent. Flamethrower is from the bounty hunter. Project is from the Jedi Consular, I think. Force Lightning is from the Sith Sorcerer. Legacy Force Sweep is, I guess, from the Jedi Warrior, Jedi Knight. Dirty Kick is from the Smuggler. Plasma Grenade is probably from the Soldier. And Force Choke is probably from the Sith Warrior. And so you can just, like, use these abilities for a while until this thing times out. And then it has quite a cooldown for a while. But it also gives you other abilities. So this is basically a very good, oh, darn it, I screwed up and am about to be killed by a boss ability. So let's see, where did we want to go? Want to go to the spaceport. Poof.
Sheesh, it's so dark. Let's see what time it is here. Oh, apparently it's always this gloomy. Lovely.
It's nice that I think they mainly do that with your first companion. That they give them a few lines that they can, that they will say on your first few worlds. A spaceship. How hard can it be? The nice thing, by the way, is that in general the hangars are, there are like predefined hangars that you can use as soon as you get your ship. And they're roughly in the same arrangement on each spaceport. Like, some are, like, you know, like, here and here, and some are here and here, but apart from that, usually they're grouped two and two, and Bounty Bounty Hunter and Imperial Agent are next to each other, and Sith Warrior and Sith Inquisitor are near each other, which, you know, makes sense because you will want to, you know, like, if you play in a with a friend, level your characters, then that you will be going together. And so it's you only have to split up there, travel, and then at the destination planet you can continue playing together. So that's a really nice detail. Wait, is there any crew skills trainers? No, I guess not. So let's go down there and see what's going on. Sneak, sneak. Oh, by the way, I forgot to say, but my immersion. It's right, you wrote that, so I should probably say that. That doesn't look good.
All right, you disgusting pile of puke! Drop your weapon and kiss the floor! This is one starship that's not getting stolen on my watch. You hear me, scum?
I'm not here to steal anything. Honest.
better that thought had gone through your filthy, subintelligent brain before you stepped through that door.
I've had 3 ships stolen this year by the Mandalorians and their unwashed cohorts.
Of course, not all Mandalorians are bad. Taro Blood was nice enough to tell me about this little tradition of yours.
If you want to die, I'm not arguing.
Karakimi, anikag nikag, kaniak gak akigwamjam.
You heard the man, at him!
Wasn't really hard. Okay. If a little bloody. Range. Huh. Got 2 spaceships over there. Let's see. Entrance seems to be in the back. Okay. So I guess we have to take this worker. Oh, and you'll want to play as well. Oh no. Thought I had blown up all of you. Whoops. Alright. Nice though, they grouped them together a little better, or I don't know, maybe they just trigger others. Other enemies, when you start attacking one group. Like, usually it's more like these were, you know, that you can kind of be close and they won't notice that you just shot their friends. Because, you know, like, compressed distances, because otherwise the game would be boring if you had to traverse realistic distances. But, so you just make everyone a little bit nearsighted and then the game is okay. But here, you know, like when we came here, suddenly that guy came running from over there. So that was a nice detail. Kind of felt more real that someone would notice that something is going on. Of course, you...
Rules or no rules, Taro Blood dies the next time we see him. Right?
That scum is living on borrowed time.
Oh, I hate this. I don't want to feel this way about anyone, but I want to make him pay.
Don't worry, Mako. It's gonna be all right.
Don't get all mushy on me. I was just saying is all. We'd better get moving. We've got a great hunt to win, right?
Oh, so we actually hacked the ship door. That was kind of... Usually they have, like, a special animation for that. That would be kind of nice. To have had, you know, the character, like, kneeling there and they're, you know, hacking and she talking over his shoulder or something. By the way, if you don't see that droid on your ship, that's because that's an unlock. But it's really useful because you can go there to repair stuff. You can sell junk. And, of course, you can sell other stuff you don't need. Do I want to sell that? Do I want to use that? I think I'll sell it. Hopefully we'll get a new one soon, and if not, I can equip more stuff in this one. Okay. So there's a few things that you can unlock that make your ship a little nicer. And like that unlocks for all the ships on all your characters if you have several. Like, we can't actually see that here.
Greetings. I am 2VR8, factotum droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
Your last master isn't coming back. Got a problem with that?
Absolutely not. He called me unpleasant names and never bathed. Not that there is anything wrong with that, Master. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Kuat Drive Yard's D5 Mantis patrol craft. Its speed and firepower are unmatched by other vessels of its class. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
Are you at least capable of providing security while I'm not aboard?
I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
That's kind of a bit of a remnant, that last question, of an older game mechanic. So, before a certain patch to the game, like, your companions were limited to doing certain things. Like, some companions were healers, some companions were tanks, others were, DPS companions or something, and so you could, like, if you picked the other class, your companion would kind of help you. But you would have to pick a certain companion for them to be really useful. And that's, of course, annoying, given how much story is hung off of the companions. And you remember the companion operations that you can trigger down here if you have a companion right now here in the ship. You know, any companions that I have are just standing around somewhere in the ship, like in Mass Effect as well. So, for example, he is here, 2VR8, or it, I guess. And Mako has to be somewhere as well. Oh, I think she's in the cockpit. Yeah, she's here. And so each one was kind of limited to something, but that was annoying because sometimes you had to take a certain companion with you that wasn't the right companion for your game style, for your play style. So what they did a while ago was just add a switch, so where you can, for each companion, for example here, you can set them to healing, tanking, or creating damage. And then, for example, if you're a healer, you'd set your companion to damage and keep them healed, basically. And so 2VR8 didn't have that, like, but he was, what you can do with him is send him to do certain jobs. So, like, companion things, like throw away your junk or things like that, and then you didn't have to have another companion do that. And that's actually a nice idea, but since the Switch is there now, it's not necessary anymore. Oh, and that mailbox on the ship is also a special unlock, so don't be surprised if you don't have that one. I'm not crying, I have a cursor in my eye. Yeah, thank you, I moved the cursor out when I read that, sorry about that. Dude, I want a droid and a spaceship. Yes, then I guess you create an account and play SWTOR. If you are not too eager to have a droid, you can also get Mass Effect, but that costs a little bit of money, but it's fairly cheap these days because it's been out for a while. Because there you get a bunch of companions and a spaceship in any of the Mass Effect games. But sadly, you don't get a droid companion as far as I remember. I don't think they're... Oh, well, yeah, in... No, in one Mass Effect game, you actually get a droid as well. So, hey, that's also an option. But, you know, Mass Effect is free, so that might be a good one. And now, one thing I want to do is... I have one of the rewards I got... There is this droid from a couple of missions called HK, I think like 53, 54, and 55 are the names. Like there were several, like one was in Knights of the Old Republic, where you met that character, and then here they had like two or three droids of the same type as well that you meet. And they were really popular. And so at some point they decided, hey, we'll make a whole bunch of HK-themed subscriber rewards. And people, after a while, got a bit annoyed with that because, you know, they were just hoping for something else, I guess. And one of the things I get was ship droid customizations. So there's one for the Republic droid and one for the Imperial droid. And that just gives him slightly different color. And also, I just remember... Where was it? I got a helmet somewhere. Yeah, they started with this jetpack, which is just, you know, one... speeder that you can use that looks slightly different. Then they gave you the HK-55 helmet, which basically looks like HK-55's head. And then they gave you the blaster I'm using and a vibro sword, which is kind of like a lightsaber but less light, but can be used by all the Jedi, and a sniper rifle for the Imperial agent. Sadly, they never got around to giving you a weapon for the trooper, or the blaster works for the bounty hunter and the smuggler, I guess. But so you get that stuff and can unlock that on any character, you get it mailed to you. Anyway, and this helmet has one fun thing about it, which is that if you have it on and your character speaks, let's turn it on just so you can see it. Well, for one, it looks kind of looks a little more Mandalorian. And I have unified colors set. Usually it's, let's do a little demo of that. So if you don't do the unify colors, Then everything has its natural color. And that helmet is kind of black and yellow. But if you're a subscriber and you can do unify colors, then those colors are kind of the same of your chest piece and of everything else. So this actually almost looks like a Mandalorian, I guess. So it's actually cooler. And there's one other fun aspect of this helmet.
So this is pretty priceless. There's a ton of buzz on the net about someone breaking into Fothra's place. Fothra's been throwing credits around to find out who did it. No takers. Nimro's paying them to keep quiet. He's having way too much fun watching Fothra suffer.
I didn't think there was anyone on Hutto who wouldn't sell their own mother for a quick credit.
You think that'd be bigger news? Beings with sense of humor located on Hutto. End of universe imminent. You know, Brayden used to say I was unique for having this holonet link. But I have no clue how I got it. I've had this implant forever. Parents must have had me teched out as a baby. Who does that?
Maybe they were thinking about your future.
That's hard to imagine. The parents who abandoned me, thinking about my future. Brayden was always encouraging me to look for my past, and I figured street kid from Nar Shaddaa, what's to know? Now, gotta admit, he was right. Something weird there.
You want any help? Let me know.
Be careful about promises, buddy, or you'll wind up volunteering to wrestle rancors on Hutto. Thanks. Really, I appreciate it.
Okay, that didn't work out as I expected, because in that conversation, actually, because it's a private one, he's taking off the helmet. So there's a nice detail with many of these helmets where they kind of have like a voice modulator in them, and so you sound a little more tinny. Imagine you're not only hunted by a headhunter, but by a color-coordinated headhunter. Yes! It's the only way to get the right bounty. Okay, so travel to Balmorra or to Nar Shaddaa. Now let's see. Nar Shaddaa is level 16 to 20. Balmorra and Nar Shaddaa is 20 to 24. So I guess Balmorra is the first one. Let's travel there then.
You notice the Great Hunt never sends us anywhere nice? The Empire's been fighting for control of Balmorra for years. Death tolls in the high seven figures.
How is there anything left to fight over?
The weapons factories are built to withstand attack. The people aren't. Let's see what Krista has to say about our job here. It's starting the Hollow now.
Welcome to Balmorra, Hunter. Your target is the right impressive Admiral Ivernus. They call him Admiral Untouchable. Spends all his time on a fancy flagship surrounded by armed soldiers. Can't kill what you can't touch, Hunter. You gotta lure Admiral Ivernus off his flying fortress and down to Balmorra. To make things even more interesting, no friendly contacts here. You gotta figure this out yourself. And don't forget, the job ain't done till you're the only hunter left standing. Good luck.
I make my own luck.
That's what I like most about you. He's a war hero, all right. Actually won some battles against the Mandalorians. Wonder if that's how he got on the list. This is interesting. Turns out one of the Admiral's toadies is in the market for a bounty hunter.
Let's get every piece of information on them you can pull down.
The job listing contact is Lieutenant Major Pirell. And get this, discretion is of the utmost importance. Whatever this is, Pirell wants it secret.
How does this secret job help us?
It's all I've got. Better than nothing, right? How about we go have a chat with Lieutenant Major Pirell at his office at the Imperial Base in Sobrek? Find out what he wants.
Okay. So now you've heard that, like, the voice is suddenly different because of the helmet. which I think is a fun detail. You probably saw what is disappointing about that helmet, which is that your chin shows up at the bottom, so you can't really use it if you want to like make your character look like a robot. And even for a Mandalorian, it's kind of not quite suitable. Sounds like a bucket. Yeah. A lot of these helmets do that, but it's kind of, it works well for first if you're like, if this is the third time you're playing that same class with the same voice actor, then that is one way to shake it up a little bit. And kind of like change the character. And of course, if you're playing a Sith or something, then that's a cool way to get like a different voice. I love that they did this thing with the effects, because you know they could have just made the helmets visual. Okay, so let's go back to to our proper helmet and hide it again. Oh, and companion. By the way, here you see those arrows, so you can actually switch through all your companions if you want. Although it doesn't show me Shay right now, which is the companion I've unlocked via a subscriber reward. But anyway, so I can put this on, and now he gets the gold and black color scheme, which looks nice. Kind of a bumblebee or wasp look, I guess. Alright. Let's put all of this stuff into our cargo hold. That as well. Mako's old stuff as well. This is the stuff we'll eventually end up using, I guess. Alright. Just a little bit of cleanup. And I guess then we're... Oh, what? Can you say something?
Welcome back, Master. I've just completed a new meal plan for your culinary pleasure.
Okay, so I guess we go back out and do this mission. Strange, the Mako has no wheels. Hi, Stimpy. Yeah, that's something I always think when someone talks about Mako in SWTOR or the Mako, that it's the wrong one. Like, this Mako looks like its only implant. Where did the human go? Or, this Mako has no wheels. How's it going? Glad to see you're back, or unlurked, or whatever.
You there, bounty hunter! We want a word with you.
You looking to hire me or what?
We've come to collect a debt from you, and we expect payment in full. We Corellians are very particular about our debts.
You killed our brother Vex, you pile of scum! You got anything to say for yourself?
I don't remember any Vex, but I've killed a lot of people.
He was that Corellian bank robber on Hutter, right? The fast draw guy.
You couldn't take him in a stand-up fight, so you shot him in the back. Now you're going to pay the price.
The name Taro Blood ring a bell? He told us how you slaughtered Vex and then killed the old man, Brayden, when he discovered your crime.
Brayden? I can't believe even Taro would stoop that low.
This pair of Corellians are nothing but Taro's pawns.
Enough. Let's fry the scum and be done with it.
You're dead!
That didn't go well. I should have picked the other answer. Whoops.
Not scared of you.
Oh. For get the snowball. It's important. I hope they don't have more siblings or relatives. Fine, you've been lurking all along. Tomorrow is your last day of vacation. Whee! Yeah, I've got tomorrow off as well, so, but I've been at work last week, so. But enjoying the few days sprinkled in between. Where I can kind of like slowly get back into the job, so that's nice. It's a nice thing about the German vacation days, I guess, that, you know, they kind of, you know, split up things a little bit. As long as I don't fall on Sundays and disappear. Or on Saturdays, which for me, since I have Saturdays off anyway, just means I can't go shopping if I need to. That's an interesting. Let's see what kind of. No, don't run away. I wanted to look at your armor. Aww. Emmy cover. Meep. Meep, meep.
Hunter, I hope you know what you're getting yourself into. Captain Rigel, Imperial Conquest Consolidation Corps. When the Empire invades, we're the ones who seal the deal. Don't suppose you're aware of the situation here on Balmorra?
It's my understanding there's some kind of battle.
Yeah, if you can call a pile of bodies a battle. The Empire invaded Balmorra in the last war, but we've been spinning our wheels in the mud ever since. Resistance fighters think they can drive the Empire off Balmorra. We're here to prove them wrong.
What does this have to do with me?
We want the best Sith agents and guns for hire in the galaxy to put this war down once and for all. The Balmorran government in exile, backed by Minister of Defense Vol Argen, is giving us fits, backing a strong faction of the Resistance. The Minister is safely off-planet, but if we break his allies here, we break him. We break him, we break the Resistance.
What do you need me to do?
That's what I'm looking for. People who want to get things done. My second-in-command, Lieutenant Davril, is masterminding Phase 1 of what we like to call Operation Breaking Point. You'll find him in Sobrick. He's got plans to blow the Balmorran Resistance sky high. I think you'll like them.
We got the mission reward for that parcel we threw earlier. That reminds me. Pop. This year's bad. Most holidays fall on weekends. Aww. The start I found was pretty nice.
But we don't have to use those guns while we are here.
Big, big guns, yes. Ah, that's the interesting armor again. That's a nice Mandalorian armor. I'm still looking like what I can get. Like, as a subscriber, you get a certain amount of cartel coins every month, and I think I get 500 more, which gets me to 1400 or something, which might just be enough to buy something like a Mandalorian armor or something. They have some really nice things there. It always depends. Like, that one. No, that's the Shavisla one. I guess something like this is what that player is wearing right now, just with a dye on it to make it red. There are a bunch. There was one really cool one here, that one. But that's 2,600. That's probably more than I wanna save for. That's a nice Mandalorian armor. Would be a pity if someone threw a snowball at it. That too, yeah. This one kind of looks interesting. If you look at right, control, left click. So how would we look with this armor? That kind of looks interesting. You know, it's kind of a good combination of like classic Mandalorian metal stuff and the, you know, the bone things that some of them had in the original trilogy. So I can kind of understand how you do that. So it's a pretty cool one. Although, you know, there are a bunch of others that are also nice and maybe a little cheaper. Let's see if we sort by price. What's the first Mandalorian armor to come up? Intelligence agent's armor set also looks quite nice and modern. Like, I'm not sure I would wear it for an Imperial agent. But it has a bit of a Quarian look from Mass Effect for it. Okay, that's a... If the helmet wasn't gray instead of red, I think that would actually be pretty nice. How does that look? Like, if I do the chest piece and the helmet, can I unify colors here somewhere? No, I can't, apparently. That's bad. I would be curious if it turns red if I turn on Unify Colors, or if it, or if the red is just these stripes and the rest is gray. Anyway, so that's what I do when I'm not playing, is like thinking, how could I make my character pretty? Although I have to say, I have like one, you know, sort of goal is to like pick a few armors. This one is also a pretty interesting one. That looks fairly modern as well. Because you can get them into your collections, of course, once you've bought them. And so I could then go into collector, and whenever I create a character of a certain type, I could just claim that armor. And then, you know, I don't have to like get anything extra. Like, I have now a dual saber and single lightsabers, so I have a lightsaber for any Jedi I make. I have this one I haven't unlocked for every character yet, but it was a reward from the command stash when it still gave you cartel market items. But so I could unlock that, I guess, for all characters and thereby get a cannon for every trooper I create. And of course I have the HK-55 stuff. So I have like nice looking, interesting, non-default weapons for new characters that I create, which is nice. I also have a few lightsaber crystals. And that's the nice thing. If you buy something from the cartel market and then pay a little bit extra in cartel coins, you get it unlocked for all your characters and can just claim it. Let's see how that would look on our character here right now. Just before we close this again. That's actually pretty nice. That the nice thing about this is, you know, you could probably have a Sith that wears this as well as a bounty hunter, and it would work for both. That's kind of nice. Whereas, like, the ones with the hood, that usually screams, you know, like, a Jedi or Sith. How much is that one? Where was it? Those are interesting ones as well. I think I scrolled down a little too far. Where was I? Scrolling in the wrong direction, I guess. No. I don't know. I think the sword order is somehow weird, or I'm not looking right. Anyway, it's not important, really. Although I do kind of wonder. Where that went. Where is it? Hello. Where is the armor I just previewed? Okay, never mind. I can't find it right now. I don't know. Animal PB. Is that Animal from the Muppets? Let's play some drums. Pirel, that's the main story mission that we want to go to, so that's the first one. Whoosh. Cool animation when you try on clothing. Yeah, they have a bunch of animations there. If you like, go here and so let's go back here. Armor, sort by price, and go back in here. You can actually like try out certain animations or certain states to know how it looks. Ah, here's the armor. Okay, now it's back. So if you preview those, yeah, like that they touch themselves when you put on that preview armor is kind of fun. But also you can like draw the weapon and see how that would look, or like see how they look running in this thing. Which is kind of nice if, you know, some of these armors kind of clip or something like that, and then you see it already. And it's also good, of course, like if you put a lightsaber in here or something, then it would preview how that looks. Let's see. I think we can actually do that here, even though we can't wear lightsabers. Yeah. Like now you see, like, you know, your character can like draw and stow the weapon, and you can kind of see how that works and like how the weapon actually looks. That's really like the whole previewing thing is really nice in Star Wars The Old Republic, that you can just like actually see most of the items. There are a few, like if they're like combined boxes where there are several items in there, like weapons and armor and something, then you see, then sometimes you only get like a box here, and then you can't preview the box because you can only preview actual items. That's a little sad, but apart from that, it works pretty well. I don't know how this preview works. Javagram, I don't know. So that might also be an issue, that you can't find out how certain items preview. Another ability to learn.
Old timer like me got a lot of tricks.
Oh,
for
look,
sale.
It's baby guard. While active, the guarded player takes 5% less damage and generates 25% less threat. In addition, so long as you remain within 15 meters of the guarded player, 50% of all incoming damage from enemy players is transferred back to you. Oh, so that means, like, people around me take the damage instead of me? That might be a little... Like, that's probably good if you're DPSing and someone else is tanking, that you can, like, reflect the damage on the tank, but I'm not sure if that's the best thing when you have friends
Come
around
back.
You.
You might learn something.
The beam color of my lightsaber does not match my armor. I want to exchange it. The armor. No, the lightsaber. Well, that's easy, actually. You can just replace the crystal. Same for the weapons, by the way. Like, the crystals you buy, you can use them in the weapon. So, like, if you go into the cartel market and go for... where is it? Categories... Dice... Where are the... I think it's under weapons. Yeah, so here are all the different, like, color crystals you can get. And you see, like, there are some that have, like, there's, like, an inner and an outer color. And, for example, there are a bunch with black. And, for example, like, black inside with a glow around it. And you can preview that as well, of course. So I don't know if you can actually make the blaster fire, though. I don't think you can. Unless... No. So with the lightsaber, you would see the color of the lightsaber, of course. Preview animation. Oh no, here. There you can see the firing. And you see, like, it has a different color now. It is the purple color. Which is kind of cool that you can, like, try the different... animations and colors as well. Like, you can see, does it really look the way you want it to? So yeah, if you like Space Barbie, this is where you get it.
Welcome to the office of Lieutenant Major Perel. I am ODX-9. How may I be of assistance?
Oh, Mako is invisible. You see that? That's only a gun here. It's either it's Mako or it's another player, but I think it should be Mako in this case.
Perel sent for me, didn't he tell you?
That's odd. I have no record of an appointment in my scheduling databanks. If I may inquire, with whom do I have the pleasure of speaking?
I'm here to speak with Perel, not answer stupid questions.
Don't really want to annoy Mako.
Welcome to the office of Lieutenant Major Perel. I am ODX-9. How may I be of assistance?
Tell your boss he has a visitor.
I'm terribly sorry, but the Lieutenant Major is in a meeting and cannot be disturbed. If I may inquire, with whom do I have the pleasure of speaking?
I'm a bounty hunter. That's all you need to know.
A bounty hunter? Oh, how interesting. I don't believe I've ever met one of you. My sincerest apologies, but the Lieutenant Major is currently in a meeting and cannot be disturbed. Thank you for visiting Lieutenant Major Perel's office. Have a pleasant day.
Get the Lieutenant Major right now.
Oh, yes, yes, right away. I'm so sorry to bother you, Lieutenant Major.
The Republic had better be bombing the planet, you worthless piece of junk.
Sir, forgive me. I had no choice. There's someone here.
I don't care who's out there, you scrap pile. I told you I was not to be disturbed.
I'm answering your encoded request for help.
Sir, shall I call security?
No. That's not necessary. Send our guest in right away. This time, make sure we are not disturbed for any reason. Any reason. Understood?
Perfectly, sir. I will unlock the door right now.
Perel is our only connection to Admiral Ivernus, so let's make the Lieutenant Major a very satisfied customer.
My apologies for the poor welcome. I never informed that idiot droid I was hiring a bounty hunter. I'm assistant to the naval attaché of the Governor of Balmorra. I specialize in intelligence gathering.
Master is wise and powerful.
This is Mergear, an amusing gift from a friend on Drummond Cass. What she lacks in intelligence, she makes up for in entertainment value. Let's get down to business, shall we? My superior, Colonel Sashius, is an incompetent fool. I toil in his shadow, though his job should rightfully be mine.
I kill him, you get a promotion.
If only it were that simple. Unfortunately, my superior is popular with the right people. But what's most infuriating is that Colonel Sashius has the full confidence of Admiral Ivernus. Colonel Sashius remains in power because he excels at hiding his gross incompetence from the Admiral. But we are going to tear down that facade.
The Colonel loses his job. Admiral Ivernus comes here and gives you a promotion.
We're going to work well together. I can tell. I want you to create problems for Colonel Sashius. Problems I'm confident he can't deal with. Your missions will involve plenty of mayhem and destruction. And the pay is quite generous. Interested?
Mayhem and destruction are my specialties.
Then it was fate that led you here. Your first target is the Okara droid factory. Before the Empire invaded Balmorra, we sabotaged the facility, turning the droids into crazed killing machines. Colonel Sashius is very close to deciphering the facility's control codes. If he does, it will bring the droids fully under the Empire's control. The Colonel cannot be allowed such a victory. I sent a data slicer to enter a code scrambling virus into the facility's computer system.
Huh. Slicers usually avoid going into deep.
I do that mistake every time.
My apologies for the poor welcome. I never informed that idiot droid I was hiring a bounty hunter. I'm assistant to the naval attack. Let my superior.
You're obviously more deserving of power.
Precisely. Even you can see it. But what's most infuriating is that Colonel Sashius has the full confidence of Admiral Ivernus. Colonel Sashius remains in power because he excels at hiding his gross incompetence from the Admiral. But we are going to tear down that facade.
I always pick that choice, brave slicer, and then it's like, well, usually slicers are cowards, and no, that's not what I wanted to say.
The Colonel loses his job. Admiral Ivernus comes here and gives you a promotion.
We're going to work well together. I can tell. I want you to create problems for Colonel Sashius. Problems I'm confident he can't deal with. Your missions will involve plenty of mayhem and destruction. And the pay is quite generous. Interested?
If I wasn't, I'd already be gone.
Indeed. Then let's discuss specifics. Your first target is the Okara droid factory. Before the Empire invaded Balmorra, we sabotaged the facility, turning the droids into crazed killing machines. Colonel Sashius is very close to deciphering the facility's control codes. If he does, it will bring the droids fully under the Empire's control. The Colonel cannot be allowed such a victory. I sent a data slicer to enter a code scrambling virus into the facility's computer system.
Very sneaky, Lieutenant Major.
Yes, I was rather proud of that plan myself. Unfortunately, it didn't work. The security team escorting the Slicer was killed by the facility's droids. Now the Slicer is trapped inside. The Slicer refuses to input the virus until I send a rescue team. I'm sending you. The Slicer's name is Zalia. Force her to input the virus into the system. Then eliminate her. No loose ends. We'll have more business to discuss when you return.
Right. So I like the kind of stories they give you in SWTOR, because it's always like these small, it's kind of a small mission, you know, in a bigger battle, and it's like everyone has their own motivations. Like that you don't just have, hey, you're the hero and you should do this and do that, and in the meantime they slow you down by having you do smaller missions or something, but rather it's, there's always missions that seem, you know, like they fit with what you're doing anyway, but there is an extra motivation, like this guy going like, I want to sabotage my boss so I can advance. And it's like this kind of like ambition and you know, small side battles, and I don't know, they're like, many other games have something that's superficially kind of like that as well, but I don't know, somehow I find them more interesting here. I guess because they're more human, you know, like more faults, like typical, like you'd have them in such a situation, no, where some people are opportunistic, some are cowardly, some are brave, and kind of, I guess they're smaller in some way, but not insignificant, you know. And it here, for example, fits for a bounty hunter, because really, as a bounty hunter, what do you want? You know, bounty hunter doesn't really care who wins. They care mainly about, you know, doing a good job and about the next paycheck. At least that's how I would play this one. And that means, you know, like you know, it's a mission that's totally fine for your needs. And it makes sense that in such a situation, you know, you would be the one to do the jobs for those people. Oh, okay.
That's a pretty sidekick, Buster.
There's also some fun abilities that the bounty hunter has, like this swirling around with the flamethrower is really fun. You know, there's some fun animations here to be had. Of course, if you played this a couple of times, you start to know the music by heart. I think he gives you a mission when you're like a trooper or something. I don't remember why he's in here otherwise, but...
Do you require medical attention? Leave well.
I also like that they hide these things pretty well. Chiss Envoy. That's a good choice of name. Oh wait, that was... No, that's the right one. Oops. Why am I being attacked? I thought the other player had attracted the enemy. Wait, Oh, I went the no. Oh, I need to go one further. Dope. Typical human vices, yeah. Or the one tough guy that admitted that he regretted ordering his daughter killed. Interesting contracts and conflicts. Yeah, it also... Like, a lot of those, of course, also depend on what you decide and how you present it to them, you know? Like, I think I've had it previously where I saved her and then kind of got... Essentially got him to kill her. Which, of course, he wasn't happy about, and then he said, you know... he said, you know, like, I'll be, I'm angry at you now, I hope we never cross paths again, or something like that. Hi, Sly. Nice to have you back. Lurking, still working. Okay. Have fun with your work, I hope. This guy comes in. Oh, this ability, and I have a shield, I remembered. Oh, and I forgot my snowball. Ability, but I guess that wasn't available right then. I wonder if I should have triggered that electric ability earlier, because I think it did a good job on that character. I'm never quite sure, you know, like, there's several ways you can do choices in a computer game. One way is to say, you know, like, the characters are all the same that you encounter, and the choices are your character's choices that influence the characters a little bit. And then there's the other way of saying the characters that you play are... That took me, like, I walked around this a couple of times the first time before I found her. The other way would be to have the characters, you know, like, to have the choices be what you would like to play. And I mean, sometimes SWTOR has this as well, like, some options are like, bracket lie, give this answer. And that, of course, means you can, you can actually choose to not tell the truth or something, and then you have a different result than if you told someone the truth, maybe. But in other games, for example, in Assassin's Creed Odyssey, there were some moments where, depending on what your answer was, the other NPC... would take the opposite position. So, like, if you said, you know, we can redeem this enemy, then the other NPC said, oh, but, you know, oh, no, I think he's irredeemable or whatever, you know. And the other way around, if you said, oh, I think that's irredeemable, then this character would suddenly be like, No, but what if we can... we shouldn't give up on them and things like that. And so... if you play the same story twice, you suddenly, like, see through it. See through the... kind of the facade, and it doesn't feel real anymore because you don't have real characters. Because, the characters are different depending on the plot. Like, sometimes that even leads to points where, in stories, a character... is evil if you at one point say, oh, you're evil, you tricked me, but turns out to be the good person if you say, oh, you're not evil. Whereas in SWTOR, if you have situations roughly like that, it's usually that your character might not find out that someone is evil. Or in The Witcher as well, in The Witcher 3, it's known for having certain missions where if you just play that mission, you think, okay, this is the straightforward way how it goes. But if you then, a few weeks later or something, return to this city, you find out it was different. Like, you think, okay, that person was innocent and is now trying to be better, and when you return, you suddenly find that person killed the entire city, and since you let them live and let them get away, you know, that person, took advantage of you. So there's many different ways, like, how you can handle decisions in a game. And I kind of like that in SWTOR, basically the characters are the characters, and you can decide for your character, and that's it, and that they don't cheat and make certain characters good or bad depending on the choice you do without giving them a reason for it. And like in this case, general whose daughter we were supposed to kill, he was like, if you come in and say, hey, so he's like the closest SWTOR gets to that cheating thing, where depending on what you answer, you know, you force him to kill his daughter, or you get him to say, well, I'll have to hide her away, but maybe I can, you know, return her to being a useful empire soldier. And, or you can just kill her, and then you might hear from him. I think then he also gets angry at you and says, you will understand that I don't want to see the face of the person who murdered my daughter anymore get lost. And then you can actually be mean to them and say something like, you'll see the face of her murderer every day in the mirror. I was just the weapon, or something like that, you know? But yeah, that's... it's interesting how they tell stories here.
You're Zalia the Slicer, right? Perel sent me.
Thank the stars. I don't know how much longer I could have held out. My reconnaissance team was evaluating the factory's computer systems when the droids overpowered us. The droids slaughtered my team. I've been stuck here for days without food, water, or sleep.
I'm here to make sure you input the virus.
You know about that? But I can't do what Perel wants. It's impossible. If I put the virus in the computer's control program, it'll trigger alarms. Those droids will swarm us.
I'll make a nice big scrap pile out of them.
There are dozens of them out there. Crazy killing machines. You can't fight them all.
We've gotten out of way worse situations. We'll be fine.
You're totally set on this, aren't you? Okay.
That little nod was nice.
Here goes nothing.
Nice animation design.
Pushover, huh?
Finally, that this rotates actually turns out to be useful. Oh, Wait, I forgot your snowball. Robots aren't nice. Fighting these robots is kind of against my instincts a bit. Whoops. Oh, I didn't pay attention, I guess. Did something happen to Mako? Okay, let's hide somewhere. They won't immediately attack us, and then we can heal up.
Try to be more careful.
Alright. Healed up. Feels a bit like cheating, you know, since you're the player. You can just respawn. I guess. I think I aggroed the droids over there by accident because they were in range. Have a snowball. Droids aren't that hard. Okay. Mako took care of the rest. Thank you. Alright.
I can't believe we're still alive.
You'll be fine now.
Oh, my stars. Thank you. You're amazing. I've never seen anything like that.
I'm bailing out of here before more droids show up. Running away never felt so good.
My contract with Perel stipulates no loose ends. That means you.
Oh. Oh, no. Please don't kill me. I swear I'll go straight. I'll never slice another computer. Just let me go.
Let's see if we can do that without annoying Mako. If Mako has a problem with that, then...
You're asking me to break my deal with Perel.
I have a family to take care of. Parents who depend on me. I'm begging you.
Perel's an idiot anyway. You'd never know if you let her go.
Okay.
I never want to see you again. Got it?
You won't. Thank you.
Good. It's always a little risk with those answers. Some of them, you know, are... will then leave you to not being able to no longer say yes. And some of them... some of them lock you in a path, and sometimes you can still choose. And sometimes, you know, like, if you don't go for the immediate dark side choice, then the next choice actually gives you more dark side points. Because it's even more evil if you give them hope first. Oh, right. I don't think we have to walk back all of this. We can just go back to Sobrick. It's so brick. Or maybe it's more like so wooden posts. I don't know. So, let's see, we'll finish this quest, I guess, and then see what we can do. Where we can leave off.
Welcome back. I take it everything went well, and the Okara droid factory is running smoothly? And what about Zalia? I trust that slicer won't be a problem.
It's like she never even existed.
The Admiral will soon see my worth.
Master is so wise.
Remain silent, my pet, or I shall discipline you again. And you don't want that, do you? Here is your payment for taking care of the slicer, my friend. Excellent work. Your next assignment concerns the local fauna. Colonel Sarsius is responsible for keeping our citizenry safe from the deadly colicoids infesting this planet.
Never heard of these colicoids before.
Colicoids are vicious, giant, insect-like creatures that devour anything in their path. Their exact origin on Balmorra is unclear. After the Empire's invasion, the Balmorrans released mutated colicoids into the wilderness. The creatures successfully bred and have become a plague on the population. The colicoids have become almost docile in recent months. Attacks are down all across the planet. That makes Colonel Sarsius look like he's got this plague under control. But we know better, don't we?
I'm not interested in guessing games, Perel.
Dope.
Welcome back.
What I want to say.
It's like she...
Here is your payment. Your next assignment...
Never...
After the colicoids have become... That makes...
You want to stir up these creatures. Make them angry.
Precisely. The only thing to do with docile colicoids... is make them hostile. The last time they attacked in force was when a survey team accidentally encountered a colicoid queen. It took 5 squads to kill her.
One of my gracious master's scout units had the misfortune of discovering a new colicoid nest while sweeping resistance hideouts. The unlucky scout who managed to crawl back raved about a bloodthirsty creature I've determined to be a queen. You see where this is going?
I'm following you.
Attacking the queen conventionally would be suicide, but my ever-thoughtful master had me devise something to assist you.
Place this sonic device near the nest entrance. It will confuse and anger the colicoids. Kill any drones and warriors you see. Eventually, the queen will reveal herself. The sonic device will disorient her, leveling the playing field so you get a fair shot. Be fast and careful.
All right, what do we get here? I guess that's the one we want. All right, and that's where we call it a day today. So we know what we're going to do next stream, which is hopefully attack a colicoid queen and get one step closer to, what is it, General Ivernus? And hopefully then be able to advance to the next planet for the Great Hunt. We shall see. So thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be back next weekend. Same time, same channel. Hopefully not same unsuccessful attempt at the earlier control boss battle. But see you then. Good night, everyone. And have a good week at work.